The OnePlus X might be the cheapest OnePlus handset to date, but it still rocks a 13 megapixel snapper on the back, as well as an 8 megapixel camera on the front. Question is, are they any good? Well, the X's camera interface is a simple affair, which keeps the clutter well out of sight. Flicking between the different modes is done iPhone style by swiping up and down the screen, with photo, video, slow motion, time lapse and panorama all on offer. At the side of the camera interface, you have the large easy tap shutter button surrounded by four simple settings buttons. One of them toggles the flash, another one turns the timer on and off, and the third switches between the front and the rear cameras. And then finally, you can switch to one of the special shooting modes, clear image, HDR and beauty when snapping photos. We like how you can quickly jump into the camera with a long or double press on one of the touch-sensitive buttons beneath the OnePlus X's screen. To set this up, all you've got to do is head to the settings and then to the buttons option. It's an effective little shortcut that can get you from any app to the camera in under a second. And if your phone is hibernating, you can also skip straight to the camera app by tracing an O shape on the screen, which impressively works pretty much all of the time. The OnePlus X's autofocus is impressively fast, not quite reaching Xperia Z5 levels, but definitely proven better than other mid-range mobiles. As a result, photos take pretty much as soon as you hit the shutter button and are almost always sharp, as long as the lighting conditions are good, of course. The only issue is the processing delay when using the phone's HDR or clear image features, which means that you can't rapid shoot in these modes. As you can see from our sample shots, the dynamic range is strong in almost every snap, even when the HDR mode isn't in play. Colours are realistically replicated and there's plenty of detail on offer, whether you're right up close to your subject or shooting from afar. In low light, the OnePlus X can automatically brighten up the scene, so your photo doesn't come out as a blurry mess. However, the photos are still quite grainy, so you're definitely best off using the basic LED flash instead. You can't shoot 4K video with OnePlus X, but you can record 1080p Full HD footage at 30 frames per second, as well as slow motion 720p video at 120 frames per second. Our HD footage looked pretty fine, if unremarkable. The lens works well to keep things in focus as you're filming and captures a decent amount of detail, though the lack of image stabilization means that everything shakes to hell if you try and walk and film at the same time. The OnePlus X's 8 megapixel front camera is fine for selfies, especially if you want to cram lots of heads into one shot, thanks to that wide angle lens. Photos generally come out quite sharp, although lacking in finer detail. Some of our indoor selfies also came out a little soft with some oversaturated colours, although to be honest, most of them look fine. Your options here are limited to beauty mode, which softens your skin and removes any blemishes, as well as a simple timer. After a solid week of use, we're really happy with OnePlus X's 13 megapixel rear camera, which is definitely a solid rival to the likes of the Wileyfox Storm and the Motorola Moto X Play. It's a pleasingly simple user experience, and you can get really sharp and attractive results with minimal effort. For the full OnePlus X review and our full camera review, check out recombu.com/mobile.